Gabriel, your heart sounds normal and healthy.
Is this how this thing works? Let's see how true it is. Stethoscope is not only one of the simplest, but also one of the oldest technologies in medicine. Stethoscope is an acoustic medical device for listening to internal sounds of animals or human beings, which is medically known as auscultation. Sounds made by our hearts, lungs, and sometimes our intestine, and also movement of blood in our arteries or veins are heard with the help of stethoscope. Stethoscope can be combined with a manual sphygmomanometer to measure the blood pressure of an individual. Now, a little history on stethoscopes. Stethoscope was first invented in the year 1816 in France, precisely Paris, by René Laennec at Necker-Enfer Malad Hospital. It was just a wooden tube then. He actually invented it because he wasn't comfortable with placing his ear onto a woman's chest to listen to her heartbeat. Seriously? Ah, honey, this one there, you know false. So this would have been the best part of medicine, where you get to put your ear on a woman's chest. Imagine what's on a woman's chest.
Challenge. How fast do we hear of this?
Yeah, I could hear you. Honey. Well, first he used a paper until he realized that a wooden tube would have done the job better. So he named this stethoscope because stetho means chest and then scope is a scope, so the chest scope. In the year 1840, Golden Bird described the stethoscope he has been using as a snake trumpet because it had only one earpiece and a flexible tube. But in the year 1851, a physician known as Arthur perfected this stethoscope by inventing the two earpiece and a flexible tube. Not until when George also perfected it to make it look a little more better than it was. In the year 1940, Ropapas and Sprague stethoscope was the stethoscope from which all stethoscopes of today were manufactured. But just that, it consisted of two sides, of which one is used for respiratory system and the other cardiovascular system. The only problem they had was their stethoscope was short and also heavy to carry. So after Ropapas and Sprague's stethoscope was abandoned, there were a lot of stethoscopes that were invented, but not up until the year 1960, where a man named David Littman from Harvard School of Medicine, a professor to be precise, invented the modern stethoscope we have today, which is much lighter and simple as compared to the previous one we had. To complete, stethoscope has always been a symbol of healthcare profession. Although recent study shows that the usage of stethoscope has declined due to the fact that the traditional way of measuring blood pressure with the help of a manual sphygmomanometer and stethoscope has been replaced by an automated one. You know one thing, when patients see a stethoscope around the neck of a doctor, they really confide in them because it has been and always be a symbol of healthcare profession. Moving on, let's talk about the parts of a stethoscope. So the stethoscope has what we call the headset. The headset has what we call the earpiece. Now the earpiece is just a soft plastic. It's made this way so that when placed in the ears can make the individual listening or using the stethoscope feel comfortable. Then moving on, we have what we call the tube. The tube comes in different colors. It's just a hollow tube, which is very, very flexible as well. Then we have what we call the chest piece. I prefer to call it the body piece because we don't only place the chest piece on the chest, but also any part of the body. Now, the chest piece, what I prefer to call the body piece, it's in the form of a drum, as you can see for yourselves. Although it's very small, it's the most important part of the stethoscope. It contains what we call the bell, which can be switched on when you turn the stem around at 180 degrees. It actually transmits low frequency sounds, unlike the diaphragm, which transmits high frequency sounds. I can't talk about stethoscopes without talking about the types of stethoscopes we have in various hospitals. So we have what we call the acoustic stethoscope. That's what we see more often. We have what we call the electronic stethoscope, the Fetal stethoscope, the Doppler stethoscope, and finally the 3D printed stethoscope. Let's look at the acoustic stethoscope first. It operates on transmitting sound from the chest piece via an air-filled hollow tube to the listener's ear. The diaphragm placed against the skin vibrates upon being hit by sound coming from the inside of the body. The diaphragm then creates an acoustic pressure sound wave that is transmitted to the listener's ear. The Fetal stethoscope is an acoustic stethoscope. It's shaped like a listening trumpet. It is placed against the abdomen of a pregnant woman to listen to the heartbeat of a fetus. It is called the pin horn, named after a French obstetrician. Charlie, I don't know how to mention that word. I will rap on for the screen. For the electrical stethoscope, it converts sound waves to electrical signals. It can amplify sound for optimized listening. Because the sounds are transmitted electrically, it can be transmitted wirelessly to your phone or tablet. It can also be recorded and played later. Doppler stethoscope, as the name suggests, is an electronic device that can detect moving objects in the blood, such as heartbeats, due to change in their frequencies. It was recently demonstrated that continuous Doppler enables the auscultation of valve movements and blood flow sounds that are undetected during cardiac examination. Finally, the 3D printed stethoscope. As the name suggests, it's a printed stethoscope. Well, it was born as a result of the blockade in the Gaza Strip. The practitioners needed a stethoscope to work with, so they printed one. Well, the 3M Littmann Cardiology 3 stethoscope is the basis of the printing of the 3D stethoscope. Now, let's move on with what the stethoscope is used for. What is its purpose in the hospital? Like I said earlier, stethoscope is used to listen to sounds internally, specifically sounds that are made when your heart beats, sounds that are heard when you are breathing. Also, it can be used to detect sounds your bowels made when they are moving in your intestine. Stethoscopes can help us detect the sounds made by your blood when they are moving through your veins and arteries. It will create mood here photo shoot.
Information we are seeing. Oh,
this is not an advertisement though, but for me, if I would like to recommend a stethoscope, the best thing to go in for is the Littmann. And you've even noticed that the recent person who invented or upgraded or modified the stethoscope was David Littmann. You can even see that the name even suggests, so just going for the right thing. But in the market nowadays, there are things. So you need to differentiate the original from the fake. How do you know your stethoscope is original? Or I mean the Littmann stethoscope is original. The diaphragm is always transparent. There's this test we call the diaphragm test, where you have to connect the earpiece or join the earpiece together and you see the diaphragm going up and down. Scanning the QR code is very important because it helps you differentiate the fake from the original. So I will demonstrate on the screen how to scan the QR code on the stethoscope box and what you should expect when you scan it. And also, Littmann comes in with variety of colors. We have the black, the red, a whole lot of colors, but me, I prefer matte black. So depending on you too, whatever color you want, you're just going for it. So finally, I've come to the end of the video, but there's something I would need you guys to comment in the comment section. So if you've ever been to the hospital before and a stethoscope was used on you, what did you think it was at that time until you watched this video? What did you think the function was? Did you think that it was actually telling the doctor something? Did you think that it was something that has voice embedded in it? Whatever you thought it was, just comment it in the comment section. Thank you very much for staying with me. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like the video, and share. And this has been it. See you guys in the next one.